The tool which has made this possible is the high-speed digital computer.
Hello and welcome to CleverIT. So you got a new computer. Good for you. I'm sure the first thing that happened when you booted it up is you noticed there was a whole bunch of stuff on there and you're wondering, does that all really need to be there? A lot of manufacturers now, they preload a lot of things. It used to be just antivirus and a couple of other things, but now you're seeing antivirus, you're seeing media applications, you're seeing games. And even though just as recently, a few years ago, disk space became available in abundance and new computers just came loaded with it, there's been a bit of a reversal in that trend. And the reason for that is SSD hard drives. SSD hard drives are basically solid state drives. That's what the SSD stands for. They are very similar to the flash memory cards that you might find in your digital camera or other such device. But of course, they're much larger and they hold a lot more space and they run very, very fast. So they become very popular in devices, in laptops, in tablets, you name it. But due to the high cost associated with these new hard drives, you're limited in the amount of disk space. And unfortunately, manufacturers are still preloading a lot of this stuff. And as a result, a fresh Windows 8.1 tablet or laptop can come with less than 10 gigs of space available. And that's just not going to work. So what we're going to do in this video is we're going to show you some of the most commonly found applications that come pre-installed on these devices. And we're going to tell you why you should or shouldn't remove it. And we'll give you a bit more information about it. So let's jump right in and take a look. So this is likely very similar to how your start screen is going to look on your brand new computer. First of all, you're going to see a series of different icons here. So these icons here are going to be a combination of the standard Microsoft Windows icons and the additional software that's been installed by the manufacturer of the device that you're using. Now, if we kind of scroll over here, you're going to see that there's a bunch of other stuff in here, and it's very likely you have even more than this here. Now, some of it may be hidden, and if you go down here, you may see even more stuff. And there is a lot of stuff that can become pre-installed on your computer. Now, there are two different types of apps that are installed in Windows. You have the apps that come from the Microsoft Store. That are going to look like things like this. The Evernote Touch, the Kindle, Amazon. These are all applications that are installed from the Microsoft Store. Microsoft Store is right here. Now, removing these is a little bit different than what you may remember from previous versions of Windows. In order to remove it, you actually need to either hold down if you're using a touchscreen or right click. You're going to see a couple of options here. Uninstall is going to be one of them. You may also have these same options show up here along the bottom. Really just depends on the version of Windows that you're using. What we're using here is a professional version of Windows, so as a result, it's made things a little bit easier. But in truth, you'll probably see a pop-up down here. If you were to go and choose uninstall, you'll get a notification here. One of the check marks here is about uninstalling from all my synced PCs. So what this means is if you have more than one Windows computer that you've logged in using your Microsoft account and you've installed applications on one, it's very likely that those applications are also installed on the other. It'll also synchronize some of the data. So if you want to remove it from all your devices, you want to select that. But maybe you don't, and maybe you only have one, in which case you can just leave that unchecked and choose uninstall. Just like that, the uninstallation is going to happen in the background. You're not really going to see anything until it's completed, but it is going to go through and it's going to take care of that for you. You can move on to the next thing. Now, there are other applications here that require a bit of a different way to uninstall that, and that's by going through the add remove programs. You can also sort of get a shortcut to that. You can go and find the application that you want to remove, and you can right click on it just like before, and you can choose to uninstall, at which point that is going to take you to the programs and features, and then from here you can actually go and properly uninstall it. Now there is another way to get to the programs and features. What you can do is you can have your charm bar come out here, just like this, click on settings, click change PC settings, and then click control panel at the bottom. From here, you'll see uninstall a program. Now, when you're in here, you'll see this, you're going to see a lot more. If you have a Dell, you're going to see a whole bunch of stuff listed here that starts with Dell. If you have an Acer, you'll see Acer, you'll see Asus, you'll see a lot of different things here depending on the manufacturer. Now, generally speaking, in terms of the programs that are installed that start with Asus or Acer or Dell or Toshiba or whoever your manufacturer is, you really want to keep those in place. There are some exceptions, but for the most part, those are add-ons to the computer that allow it to do certain enhancements. It's not generally garbage applications. Things like power control, for example, which allow it's essentially that manufacturer's way of controlling the power consumption specific to that device outside of what Microsoft can provide. So as a result, you want to keep that in mind as you're going through and looking at these items to uninstall. What we've done is we've sort of preloaded some of the more common ones that you will see. Bing Bar. What is Bing Bar? Well, Bing Bar is, if you open up Internet Explorer, and you see this bar along the top, that is Bing Bar. Okay. You're also going to see here there's another bar underneath. This is a bar that's installed with Norton Antivirus. You'll see it's having some trouble loading. It's not the greatest of toolbars, and as a result, it does sort of lag. So here it is here. You see this quite commonly with a lot of antivirus. Your computer, if it was installed with Norton, may have this. If it was installed with McAfee, it may also have a different bar. But essentially, they do the same thing. And they're designed to provide an extra layer of protection. But generally speaking, it really just bogs down Internet Explorer. If you really want a more secure browsing experience, what I would recommend that you do is in an Internet Explorer browser, go to google.com/Chrome and install Google Chrome. That will give you a much faster and a much more secure browsing experience than what is offered by Internet Explorer. So Bing Bar is definitely something that you can remove. If you don't use that, if you're not the type of person that uses the toolbar with Internet Explorer, get rid of it. The next one that you're going to see here is Corel WinDVD. You may have Corel WinDVD. You may also have another one that is quite common, which is the PowerDVD. Now, this actually came as part of the Media Suite. So it's not listed here, but essentially you'll see a Cyberlink PowerDVD, or you may even see the manufacturer's name. So Asus PowerDVD, powered by Cyberlink, things along those nature, but you'll see PowerDVD. So PowerDVD and WinDVD essentially are applications that will allow you to watch DVDs that you have, Blu-rays if your computer supports it, things of that nature. Now, if that's something that you plan on doing, you don't want to remove these applications because they are the only way that you're going to be able to run these DVDs or Blu-rays without installing some other piece of software. So generally speaking, you want to keep that in. And that brings us to another point as well. When it comes to any of this stuff, you want to be very careful about what you remove, because in many cases now with the newer computers that are being released, they don't have any physical media, which means that they don't come with CDs, DVDs, recovery discs, anything like that. As a result, if you want to go and reinstall something that was pre-installed in your computer, you might have trouble finding it, because most often cases, these are not free applications. The Cyberlink ones, the Corel ones, they're not free. So you are provided with essentially a free license that was paid for by the manufacturer. Okay. So as a result, you may not always want to remove it. Cyberlink can also have other stuff like the label print, like UCAM. Label print is basically just something that allows you to print off labels, something that Word kind of already does itself, so you don't necessarily need that. The other thing is UCAM. UCAM is basically for using your webcam. Now, what you're going to notice here is with the sizes. I mean, if you look at this, UCAM is almost half a gigabyte of space. Now, if you have a laptop that doesn't have a whole lot of disk space on there, that's going to be a big problem for you, right? So, you know, removing some of these things with really large disk space usage may help you free up some of that extra valuable disk space that you may not have. A lot of the newer laptops that are coming with SSD drives and things like that, they have a smaller footprint. A lot of the Windows 8 tablets that you can get now that do come preloaded with a lot of the stuff, that does still happen, may have a small amount of disk space available. So right off the bat, you could be looking at less than 10 gigabytes of disk space before you've even installed anything yourself or downloaded anything, okay? So it's important to keep that in mind. As we move down here, these Microsoft ones, anything starts with Microsoft, you generally just want to leave that alone. That includes Microsoft Office. Even if you don't have Office installed, you can just leave it in there. It's not going to bug you. It's not going to do anything. My WinLocker 4. So this here is something we see very, very, very common, okay? My WinLocker is essentially a backup and encryption software. I don't really know any client who's actually kept this on their computer, and we quite often remove it when we go and perform regular maintenance on a computer because for most people, the value is just really not there. On your computer, you're also going to find a bunch of things with Nero. Nero is actually very similar to what CyberLink provides in that it has backup software. That would be Nero Backup. It has software for playing movies and DVDs and things like that. Nero is just a different manufacturer. So again, what it comes down to is what you intend on using your computer, laptop, or tablet for. If you have no intention of actually going through and creating, watching movies on these computers, or you're not going to use a backup, or you have another solution, like for example, CrashPlan, which is what we very, very highly recommend, then you don't need any of these things, and you can remove them. You're also going to see here some kind of antivirus. All new computers will come with an antivirus. You'll see Norton Security is a common one, Norton 360. You'll likely also, the other option is McAfee. Very rarely do we see anything other than Norton or McAfee. Generally speaking, not really big fans of either Norton or McAfee. Now, if you look at any of the reviews over with regards to antivirus, Norton and McAfee generally rank quite high when it comes to the their ability to detect viruses and remove viruses. The problem with both applications and why we generally don't recommend it is that they tend to be very bloated. They use up a lot of resources on the computer, a lot of disk space, a lot of memory usage. And when you do decide that you want to go with something else and you go to uninstall it, I have very, very frequently come across major issues that come. The only exception to this is if you install McAfee early on in your computer's life, McAfee and Norton, then generally you don't run into as many issues. So when it comes to choosing as well between an antivirus, free or paid, as a general rule of thumb, you want to go with a free antivirus. The paid ones do offer some additional security. If you have a laptop that you're using and taking with you a lot and plugging it into different networks and maybe connecting to untrusted networks, then it would likely make sense for you to go with a paid version versus just a free one. QuickTime is usually installed, and oftentimes it's just installed for another thing. And actually, that brings up a really good point as well. One of the things that you don't see in here is some of the Adobe products, Adobe Reader, Adobe Flash. Those ones you want to keep in place. You are going to get nagged to update Adobe Reader. You do want to say yes to update it. Usually it's security related. Same thing with Java. If you have Java installed, you want to update that. But pay close attention when you do the installation of the update because it will try and install things like a Bing bar or an Ask bar or some other piece of software. So you need to just be wary of that because you can end up, Java has been known as well to install McAfee antivirus even if you already have one, and it's a bit of a nightmare. So you just want to be wary of that. Spotify. Now, Spotify is a streaming music service. Generally, you see that loaded up. But most people just remove it. I mean, for all the services out there, Spotify is very popular, but you don't see it being used quite often here in Canada. And then finally here, you're going to see the Wild Tangent Games app. I see Wild Tangent on more computers than I can count. I mean, they're on almost every new computer that comes off the assembly line now. And essentially, it allows you to get access to games. I very rarely come across customers who actually use it. So uninstalling it would probably be recommended, unless you are, a big fan of playing these little games that you can download through there. Just be wary, especially if you have to hand over your credit card, because like anything, if you have to hand over your credit card, it's for a reason. It's because they want to charge you for different things, updates, things of that nature. So that's pretty much all you need to know for a new computer and what applications that you should remove. If you have any more questions, please feel free to send us an email at info@cleverit.ca. You can post a comment in the YouTube comments below. We'll do our best to answer it there. Or visit our website. We have a live chat feature and we would love to answer any questions that you have. We hope you enjoy your new toy. We hope you enjoy the new year, and we'll see you again real soon.